Hello, Diz Centers. My name is Etalyx, and I'm here today with a quick look at the upcoming Hitman game currently in beta form. But perhaps you've never played a Hitman game before, so I want to go over a basic but rapid assassination. First, we need to find our route to the target. The front entrance, too obvious, and the guards won't let us in. So we find a way around, through the cargo area, where we'll pick up a mechanic uniform. A disguise! Don't worry, he's just taking a little nap. Now we can board through the cargo bay, no problem. The other mechanics just wave and let us through. Mingle with the locals a little bit and find the target resting at the bar. But we can't get too close to a bigwig like that in just our yellow vest. Fortunately, we learned a thing or two about hammers in the brief stint as a mechanic. We need to make sure our friend is nice and comfy in his cryogenic chamber. Blend in back on deck at the bar while we watch and wait for Mr. Ritter to make his move. Mr. Norfolk in his fancy white suit has made a special appearance. That'll be important later. Can't follow them into their private quarters as a waiter, so maybe we can find an open window. Silent pistol makes a loud clanging noise that only I can hear for some reason. It's time to make our escape, of course, but the front is still closed off because down the stairs waits a higher-up who can recognize all of the waiters' faces, and he'd catch us. So we need to find a back exit. This leads to a closed-off locked gate, but there's a convenient crowbar lying around nearby. A quick pry of the fence, and we're home free to the escape vehicle. No one's even found the body yet. Mr. Norfolk must be particularly talky today. Well, that wasn't so bad. Seemed pretty easy. As well it should. It's the tutorial genius, and that's the way that they wanted me to complete it the first time through. But the big selling point of Hitman is open-ended missions that allow you to complete it in a variety of ways, and that's what I'm scrolling through here on the challenges, also called feats by the game, that encourage you to replay a mission with different tools and perhaps dunking your target's head into a toilet or dropping a life raft canister on his head as he passes under. There's a number of different methods to dispatch of your target and perhaps a bunch of unsuspecting casualties at the same time for you to try to challenge yourself, and that is the main driving point I want to make about Hitman. It's a game about challenging yourself. You can do things very easily if you want to. The game is very easy, even in the tutorials. Walk to your target, shoot him, escape. You can do that if you want to, or you can do the more creative approach. Let's try one of those creative approaches. We've got some new tools, we've got some coins, we've got a remote detonator explosive. They even have guns here if you want them. Hey, Mr. Norfolk, is that you just hanging out next to this car? You look like a rich guy. You look like you could use a few extra coins. That's what I'm doing. I got 3 coins. I'm tossing them one by one. Mr. Norfolk, in his confused and vulnerable, greedy state, is chasing down each one. Who's throwing those? What is that noise? Don't worry, Mr. Norfolk. You'll find out soon enough. Or you won't. That's right. We've lured him all the way back. Out of the view of any guard or pedestrian, to subdue him and drag him backward. No one will ever find him again. I could be more violent if I wanted to and snap his neck, but you know, I'm kind of a nice guy. I just have one target. I'm a very efficient hitman. We're gonna steal his white suit, and now we have a new array of options available to us to take down this exact same mission. In fact, we can go through the front stairway entrance. They recognize me as Mr. Norfolk because I've got that flamboyant white suit and giant pimp hat. So they don't care. Nobody really knows how to recognize Mr. Norfolk's face. Apparently, I am a mystery. I found my target and I can talk to him in person instead of waiting behind the bar, pretending like I'm just an innocent crew member like I did previously. Whereas I couldn't go back into the private quarters, I now get invited into those same private quarters. I've just made this mission a lot easier. No one's hassling me. No one's wondering, is that actually Mr. Norfolk? I found the perfect disguise. So this is just an example of one of the many ways that you can complete this. There's probably, I don't know, at least 4 main ways that you can finish just the tutorial mission, aside from getting more creative, say, with rat poison, or with explosives, or just shooting him to death with a gun. Unfortunately, there's still some huge bugs in Hitman, as you can see from using that fiber wire, which didn't quite go all the way around his neck for whatever reason, but now we're dragging him with said wire and setting him up into a nice pose here on the bed. Nobody will even know that he's dead. What a perfect picturesque pose you've made for us right there, Mr. Ritter. You should get into modeling. We're even able to make it back to the escape car through the front entrance. No one can recognize Mr. Norfolk. Nobody's found his body since I just knocked him out. Had they found his body, they'd be able to reawaken him and, of course, set off the alarm. Now, in Hitman, people don't just enjoy doing things the way they're supposed to. Part of the fun is causing as much mayhem as you can, and sometimes that means equipping a fully automatic rifle, seeing how many guards you can take out before they get you.
Jesus, I heal people! You can't kill me!
And occasionally, picking out the annoying pedestrian. The chaos, the mayhem, still very much a part of Hitman here, where you got the open sandbox. There's not a fail state where you shot the wrong guy, game over. I mean, obviously, sometimes you're going to need to kill someone in a particular way to get away with it, but the fail state is getting caught, getting arrested, or most commonly, getting killed by people that see through your disguise. Now I want to direct your attention to one of the most important mechanics in Hitman. See the opportunity revealing text at the bottom of the screen. This indicates that we're eavesdropping on a couple of mechanics across the fence, describing a way that they need to do a little bit of maintenance on a jet that they're harboring in the hangar behind them. And after we listen to what they have to say, it's marked in the intel and we can track it. This is both a blessing and a curse. It's good because there's a number of these per mission, probably four or five, maybe even more for some of the bigger levels, and they give you alternative fun ways to take out your target. The bad news is that by tracking this, through the default gameplay settings in Hitman, we have these mini objectives. Top left, get a security disguise. Okay, well, that's vague, except it's not, because those mini objectives will pinpoint the exact person that you need to steal that disguise from. In this case, the guy just dumped inside that container. See, now we need to investigate the safety protocol. It has a little light bulb icon over the safety protocol. So it's guiding me right to it. This has turned from an open-ended sandbox experience to A to B to C to D to complete the mission. And that's boring. Having those leading you breadcrumb trail style through the level makes the game so easy it becomes trivial. Yes, I'm aware this is still a tutorial training mission, but the point remains. I hate it. That is why I am so grateful that the developers knew this would be a point of contention among players. By default, these gameplay settings have made Hitman oh so easy. But you can go in and manually change everything. So the opportunities I was just talking about, there's a minimal and an off setting. So you can turn the notifications off entirely. Instinct, that allows you to see everyone through walls across the whole mission, can be turned off. The minimap can be off. NPC icons off. Attention off. Everything that will make the game much harder and more rewarding if you want to go in blind and try to discover all of these cool ways to take down your targets without having the game guide your hand and lead you directly to them. That's at your fingertips. That's why I said earlier, Hitman is very much as difficult a game as you want to make it. You can play through it with default settings and have a very easy time. You can just run in, throw a hammer at somebody, and shoot your target with a pistol, and that's going to be it. The mission's over, you completed it, as long as you don't get caught on the way out, of course. Hitman is as easy as you want it to be. But if you want to do things the more fun way, if you want to take out your target more creatively, that is completely within your power, and it's kind of a game of imagination as far as that goes. There are a lot of different set-in-stone ways that you can take out your target, but it's up to you to decide that you want to do it, and replayability is going to be the main factor in this episodic game. I guess when they release in March, it's only going to have a few missions, maybe one or two even, beyond the beta, but the fun is going to come in replaying them, making the game more difficult for yourself, and trying to figure out these alternative routes. So this time, I want to take this wrench and bash this mechanic over the head with it as hard as I can so I can take his mechanic uniform and then go meet Mr. Jasper Knight personally. Instead of sneaking and slinking into the room and shooting him in the head, we're gonna take him down to the jet, which I may have tinkered with a little bit here or there, made a few adjustments of my own. By taking a listen to the opportunity from earlier, from the two mechanics behind the fence, I learned that they needed a mechanic to go up to Mr. Jasper Knight himself, Jasper Knight, lead him down to the jet, and run through the safety protocol. Especially with regards to the ejector seat. So we got the clipboard here, He's gonna take the helm in the cockpit, and we're gonna see if we can't locate that ejector lever.
One step at a time.
I should have mentioned that the whole time working on the other side of this jet are a couple of senior mechanics who would recognize me and have seen through my disguise a couple of times. I had to get around them to fix this jet, make it work a little bit better. I see that you've located the ejector lever. You didn't know this was an aerospace astronaut program, did you?
Oh my god, did that just happen? That shit was definitely not part of the plan.
Oh, that just happened, all right. Is it just me, or would it be so much more rewarding to see the fruits of your labor from your own third-person perspective instead of going to a cutscene? Seems to cheapen the effect a little bit. I'd rather just be Hitman Agent 47 and watch as the ejector seat lifts off. For all the good that Hitman has, it definitely has its fair share of weird quirks. I just took out that guard. Two other guards, to my surprise, heard him. It wasn't a completely silent takedown. They were facing the other way. I started strangling him, and they hurt. So I applaud that. Most games, you can silent takedown a friendly from feet away, and they won't notice. So these guys do. Unfortunately, it ends there. I just snapped his friend's neck while he's bent over observing what's going on in the corpse. And while the third guard's watching, I take out his friend. They're really confused now, and I'm just going to pretend like I'm going to let them arrest me. The final guard gets so close to me, I can smell the gunpowder emanating from his pistol. Rookie mistake, Rent-A-Cop. Of course, that's close enough I can initiate a hand-to-hand duel. He won't shoot me, and I'll take him down. So it's just a little bit too easy to take out those three guards who pretty much knew I was there the entire time. So I'm a little bit critical of the artificial intelligence. Seems like the guards could behave a bit more appropriately, given the circumstance that's unfolding before their very eyes. The only other thing I need to warn you about is the console version of Hitman. I played this on PS4, as you probably guessed from the button prompts. However, I plan to play it on PC because I'm assuming that I'm going to get 60 frames per second on the PC. Don't know that for a fact, we're going to find out pretty soon. On the PS4, however, I regret to say it felt like the frame rate was anywhere between 20 and 30 frames per second, and occasionally would dip lower when large crowds were on the screen. So that felt particularly choppy, and I would wait for a PC release and be very cautious if you're going to play this on console and look up some other reports on frame rate issues. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this quick look into the Hitman beta. More of a glorified demo, I guess, but that's kind of become the norm nowadays, quote-unquote beta. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hit me up with any thoughts and opinions down in the comments below, and let me know what you think. My name is Etalyx. I'll see you next time.